Coming up, the final escape has almost come to an end.
In a matter of minutes, one team will be flying back to civilization in a helicopter, knowing that they have conquered Scorpion Island.
Will it be Team Sting?
Or will it be Team Claw?
It all hinges on one last climb. Bronte versus Michael.
Bronte has a slender head start, but if anyone can beat her, it's Michael.
There's never been a tougher escape, and the island knows it. But what it doesn't know is who'll escape its clutches. Welcome to Scorpion Island. I'm Miley.
And I'm Johnny.
You join us on the final day as Team Sting and Team Claw race to escape.
But who will triumph and who will be left on this most devious of islands?
10 brave adventurers have represented the island powers. Strength.
Balance.
Speed.
Bravery.
And stamina.
And all 10 have drawn on every last ounce of these powers just to keep pace with their rivals and this devious island.
Skydiving in from 4,000 meters high was just the start. In their adrenaline-fueled journey, the legendary Team Sting and Team Claw have gone head-to-head in intense trials and challenges.
Come on!
At the end of these momentous battles, Team Sting had won the most island challenges,
whilst Team Claw had won the most totem trials.
Everything has built up to their last and toughest challenge, and Sting's incredible winning streak rewarded them a massive 50-second head start at the beginning of the final race to escape.
Whoa, race to escape!
And despite a valiant effort, Team Claw couldn't stop Sting rampaging through the strength, balance, and stamina zones. Sting duly won the precious 30-second head start to take to the final climbs at Freedom Rock.
Claw were glad of their totem trial prowess, and the sight of their higher totem piece steps gave them a much-needed psychological boost. The final escape has all come down to this, the last speed and bravery challenge. The teams have been bounding over their totem pieces and up the face of Freedom Rock, unthreading sections of their scorpions as they go. And we've already seen 4 amazing head-to-head races.
Abby trounced Angus as they took the outer pincers away.
Shia pipped Brandon as they dispatched the inner pincers.
Harriet just made it up before Maddie as they removed the bodies.
And Rachel thrashed Janardan as they unwound the legs.
So now all that's left are the scorpions' tails, and taking them away in the final one-on-one race, it's strength power captain Michael and speed power captain Bronte.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Oh, I'm so nervous.
Yeah. Oh, this is where it ends.
Yeah. Last challenge on Scorpion Islands.
Oh, I'm gonna cry.
Scary.
Well, they sound nervous, but they're taking their positions at the base of Freedom Rock. All of Michael's stay on Scorpion Island must now culminate in this final climb.
Sporty Michael arrived on Scorpion Island with a quest for adventure.
I never thought I'd jump out of a plane. I never thought I'd be doing it, especially at the age of 12. It's just amazing.
He impressively won the power of strength in the battle for the powers.
Strength, I'd rate myself about 7 or 8 out of 10.
and prove to be a courageous member of Team Sting and a valued team player.
I have quite an adventurous side to me, so I could do lots of the challenges really well. We've got a really good, strong team, and I'll be giving them support and encouragement, and hopefully with that, they'll get through.
Now, for the first one over there.
If any of the other teammates, like, freeze or something because of fear, I can cheer them on.
Vital to Team Sting, Michael rose to every challenge as if it was his last. He was terrific in Tracks of Terror.
Devastating in Danger Dunk.
Brave in Bug Banquet.
And he was not afraid to indulge in mind games.
I saw an eel. Hurry, an eel. Eel.
Then there's a leech on your head. Don't worry,
they're not human. I think you're going to try it.
Don't worry, I like leeches.
There's one on your hand.
He had a vivid imagination when it came to guessing what the island was up to.
There's definitely going to be a twist. Maybe you're in, like, a tunnel, and there's, like, the people above are directing you, and they have to lift, like, big bamboo canes or something out.
Or maybe they'll have, like, you'll have to put a muffler on your voice.
But now he knows exactly what the island has in store, and every last ounce of strength Michael has must go into this final climb. And it will.
Bronte's hopes and fears in her time on the island must now inspire her.
Bronte arrived on the island wanting to step out of the shadows of her brothers and do something for herself.
It was amazing. It was like being a bird, and that's really obvious, but he was turning in, I was just talking. Oh.
She impressively won the speed battle for the powers.
The power I've been awarded is speed, and that just means I'm one of the fastest.
And immediately brought her calm assurance and natural-born leadership to Team Sting.
If I do it like that, I mean really urgently stop, like...
However, amid emotional scenes, the island ruthlessly made Bronte swap to Team Claw.
I was really upset last night. I was, like, in tears, because I've worked really hard with that team, and they feel like family, because we've gone through, like, a lot with each other.
She bounced back and brought organisation and leadership to unfocused Claw. The comeback had begun.
We're like seeds that she just came over and watered us to make us more, like, we sprout out and show real potential.
Bronte risked the wrath of her old team by taking a chant from them.
That was Sting.
Yeah, who?
He stole it.
I didn't steal it, it was mine.
But all is fair in love and challenges, and it was clear to see that Bronte still had the respect of all the adventurers.
Are you ready?
We were born ready! Woof, oh yeah!
So, this is it. The last ever one versus one. The ultimate head-to-head with the ultimate prize. Winner takes all. Strength Power Captain Michael has been impressively consistent throughout, and nothing suggests the final climb will be any different. Sting would not want anyone else in this position.
Bronte proved she was a good leader, choosing the right teammate for the right challenges.
Yeah!
But now she's on her own, with nowhere to hide, and the head starts have been overturned a staggering three times already. It's too close to call, and they both have their teammates' dreams on their shoulders. But who will realize them? Who will escape from Scorpion Island? And remember, in this final head-to-head, they've got to remove their scorpion's tails. Plus, as Rachel won the last race, Bronte has a 30-second head start. It's a great help, but as three of the four previous races have gone against the head start, there's still every chance Michael can take victory for Sting.
And Bronte's off. It's the final of the final race to escape from Scorpion Island. And she's also got those totem power pieces.
And she's already made it to the ladder. This is a quick start from a speed power captain.
So much pressure on these last two power captains now.
But which of them will win this race for their team? Michael's getting set to go.
And he's off.
And this is a fast start too.
Michael is racing up the ladder, and it looks like he might be catching Bronte up. Oh, no!
But he's back on the ladder straight away.
And Bronte can see Michael's really gaining ground on her.
Oh, no! But no, he's not letting these slips put him off.
Can he catch Bronte up?
Imagine how much pressure this puts on Bronte. Michael's breathing down her neck now.
So can she keep her pace up?
Well, Johnny, Bronte is the speed power captain, and throughout her time on the island, she's moved amazingly fast, and she's often done so at just the right moments to snatch victory. But she's never before had to use her speed in such an unforgiving situation. This is rock hard.
Oh, but she's made it up to claw Scorpion's tail. But now she's got to untie it.
She seems to be finding it really difficult to unknot.
Oh, look, she's taking her glove off. Is this going to make it easier to untie? Yes, she's got it. Oh, no, she's dropped it.
Bronte takes her glove off to help her untie the ribbon. It seems to work, but then she lets it slip. And it slides down the cliff face. So now she's going to have to keep clambering up the cable ladder with an ungloved hand. And that can make it a really painful climb.
So this is a great opportunity for Michael to pull this back for Team Sting.
But Bronte's reached across, and she's untying the other end of the ribbon. These knots are so hard to untie when you're way up there on the cliff face.
But Michael seems to be fine. Oh, no!
Michael starts to move across to the far ring, but totally loses his footing and crashes into the cliff face. It's a massive smash, and it could be a real delay.
But throughout his time on the island, we've seen Michael show exactly why he is a strength power captain, relentlessly powering his way on through utter exhaustion and making some remarkable recoveries. Now the entire fate of Sting is in his hands. If they're going to be the team which escapes from Scorpion Island, they need him to mount the comeback to end all comebacks here. This is crunch time.
First of all, he's got to get back on the ladder and fast, because Bronte's freed the end of Claw's ribbon.
And it seems as if she's taken off her other glove to do it. Oh no, she's dropped it. The ladder is really going to hurt her hands as she climbs now. Nightmare.
That could be good for Michael, and he's just reached Sting's Scorpion's tail. Oh no.
Well, he's back on, but it looks like he's going for the nearer ring.
They're side by side on the cliff face. Bronte's heaving herself upwards towards Claw's final ring, but she must be exhausted.
Now Michael needs to untie this really quickly. And yes, he's done it. This challenge is not over yet, but if he's gonna win it for Sting, he's just got to untie the other end of the ribbon even faster. Bronte's nearly there. She's nearly done it for Team Claw.
Oh, no!
No, she's okay, and she's really increasing her lead.
She's almost there. She's at the finish line.
But Michael is using absolutely all of his remaining strength here.
He is not giving up.
But there's no stopping Bronte now. And yes! She's across!
She's done it. Team Claw have won. Team Claw have escaped from Scorpion Island. Everything they've worked for over these last few weeks has come down to this, and Bronte has brought it home. Abby, Harriet, Rachel, Bronte, Brandon, Team Claw have escaped from Scorpion Island.
Bronte! I love you! So it's a hero's welcome at the top of Freedom Rock for Bronte. Team Claw are ecstatic.
I want it for Claw. Claw have won, my team have won.
And Michael's almost finished his climb now. This is such a tough position to be in, but he's still giving it his all. And yes, he's across the line. Of course, he'd rather have finished first, but this is still a monumental achievement, even if it's not the result Sting were looking for.
You've done so well. Well done.
Great sportsmanship from Brandon and Abby there. Claw might have beaten Sting, but they still want to give a fellow power captain the respect he deserves.
You've done so well. You were so close.
You're right, Brandon. It was close. What an incredible final face-off this was.
Bronte made good use of a head start and maintained a terrifically fast speed throughout, never really giving Michael a chance to catch up. She did struggle a bit with the ribbon, but took the bold move of abandoning her gloves and never looked back.
Michael got off to a fast start, but had difficulty climbing the ladder, and he took some massive falls. He showed real mental strength in battling on, but just couldn't achieve the huge burst of speed he'd have needed to win.
Which means Claw will be the team that escapes from Scorpion Island. And of course, these guys are going to leave the island in style.
What an amazing moment for Team Claw. They have beaten the island.
You can really tell just how much they're looking forward to getting on that helicopter and escaping from Scorpion Island.
Adventurers are seconds away from boarding the helicopter and finally escaping Scorpion Island.
And here come Team Claw now.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Thank you. How are you all feeling?
So great.
Oh, fantastic. You are the winners.
Yes.
Does it feel good to be winners?
Oh, yes.
You've worked so hard for this, haven't you guys?
Yeah.
What would you say your highlight has been of Scorpion Island?
Totem Trials.
Yeah.
And just when Bronte came up there and screamed,
that was so... And just meeting new people as well. It's just amazing.
The end of it.
Just finishing it. Like, climbing the cliffs,
jumping out of the plane. Just everything.
Everything.
Absolutely.
Just finishing it. Like, the journey, the whole, like, Scorpion Island journey is just amazing.
Bronte, you've been on quite an amazing journey because you started on Team Sting.
Yeah, I never thought I'd be standing here, like, in yellow, like, being happy with Claw. I changed teams and I've been with each team pretty much equal amount of time and they are my family now and just I can't believe I've won with them and just so glad I did.
Guys, you're all clearly very emotional.
It's amazing. I've made so many good friends. I mean, we've been all each other have for 3 weeks, so it's just amazing and I'm gonna be so sad to go.
Of course, yeah.
Guys, what do you want to say to each other? Well, you know what, Team Claw? Your helicopter awaits. You've escaped from Scorpion Island.
Thank you.
Off you go. Well done. You made it.
Winners, Team Claw have escaped Scorpion Island and reflect on this most momentous of experiences.
I think I've changed quite a lot since coming down to Scorpion Island because I've became a lot more independent, a lot more, I suppose, brave.
I'm a bit different to the Brandon that first arrived, as I used to be giggling and less focused, but now I would say that I'm more focused.
When I first arrived, I think I was a little bit scared of doing a new thing, you know, being on a, whether it's a new team or doing a new challenge or just going for it, you know. I didn't want to do that many challenges because I didn't want to lose them. Whereas by the end, like, as you get into the end, you just think, oh, I'll go for it, and if it works, that's amazing. If it doesn't, whatever.
I sort of just realised that if there's a lot of people trusting you to do it, then you can actually do anything that you set your mind to.
I think the best thing about the full experience has definitely been the skydive. It was the most amazing thing I've done in my life, and I don't think I'll ever be able to do anything that will top that.
My highlight of Scorpion Island will most probably be meeting new friends and learning new things. And I've came here and it's just been so great, and I've loved every minute of it.
At first I was mortified that I'd left Sting and I was suddenly going on to like the enemy's team, but then after a while, like the next morning, I thought, oh, you know, new challenge, new day, and it's made my journey and my time here even more interesting, and I'd say a lot better.
Well, I think my highlight about Scorpion Island is winning the whole series, because it was absolutely fantastic.
I liked suspension because it was just fun to show that I could do that and I could beat other people, and I was actually physically strong as well, even though I was the smallest.
When I go back home, I'll describe this experience as the most unbelievable, amazing thing I've ever done.
Scorpion Island, I've loved every minute of it. It's just a once in a lifetime chance. You never get to climb up a cliff face in your life and do challenges and try and compete and beat the other team.
I didn't think it'd be like this. I didn't think it'd be so emotional. I just thought it'd be a big competition and, you know, working as a team, the whole drill. But it was so much more than that. Your teammates became your family, not just someone you had to do challenges with. It's actually life-changing. It's amazing.
If I could describe Scorpion Island, I would describe it as a fantastic, super fragile, casualist, essentially delicious place to be.
But it takes two teams to create such a close competition, and Team Sting may not have won, but have still been on an incredible journey.
Scorpion Island has changed me because now I'm a lot more stronger and more competitive.
I think some of the ways Scorpion Island's changed me is that I'm a bit nicer now and I make friends more easily.
I've kind of become, I think, more mature.
I think I've learned to get on with people even better than I did before, and to be more responsible for myself.
The absolute highlight of being on Scorpion Island was probably at the beginning when we skydived out of the aeroplane.
My biggest highlight from being on Scorpion Island has been making new friends and doing all the challenges.
I'm definitely not afraid of anything now. And I skydived. That was fun.
Probably my favourite island challenge was probably the bone collector. I really enjoyed being the stamina power captain for that and hanging upside down, climbing down ropes.
My favourite totem challenge would be in the line of fire. Even though I got drenched, it was still really fun, and it was like fun to pick which pipe you had to pour the water down.
I did have a bit of a fear of heights, but I've definitely overcome that with a lot of challenges that we've been doing.
If I had to describe Scorpion Island, it would be is the best thing that I have ever done in my entire life.
It was a really fantastic journey and a fantastic experience, and the most wonderful experience. I made new friends.
It's like fantastic, overwhelming, and you always get different emotions every different challenge you do. So it would take a lot more than one paragraph to describe the amazing Scorpion Island.
When like I'm an old man, I can like sit around and tell my grandchildren all about it and like tell them all the different experiences and the feelings of what it's been like on here, and excitement, happiness, tiredness, sadness. Like, it's been everything jumbled into one.
At last, the spirit of the powers have been released. And a tribute to the powers so memorably demonstrated by the five brave adventurers of Team Sting will take their place.
They have faced monumental trials and challenges and have fought gallantly in each and every one.
Even and in defeat, they have represented these five powers with an incredible spirit and will forever be proud guardians of Scorpion Island and an inspiration to future adventurers.
Civilization, knowing they have joined the elite few who have ever escaped the island's clutches.
Five adventurers who didn't even know each other just a few weeks ago have come together as one team.
Well, you can't go to a beach without going in the sea!
And have formed bonds that will last forever.
All the trials, all the tribulations, it's all worth it now.
Five proud adventurers. Bronte.
Brandon.
Rachel.
Abby.
And Harriet.
Team Claw have rewritten Scorpion Island history.